So this is a walkthrough for how to import a Blender model into Microsoft Flight Simulator 2020 using the exporter that's available from fsdevelopers.com. And I already have the SDK installed for Flight Simulator, and I'm using a version of Flight Simulator which was installed from the Xbox store using the Game Pass for PC. So I'm going to create a folder to hold my project. Somewhere to hold my sources. A folder to hold my models. A folder to hold my scene once I've placed the models. So now, having set up this basic folder structure, I'm going to go into Blender, model up a object of which I will then set up in my project and be able to then continue with inside Flight Simulator. So here is my basic cube in Blender. I'm going to get rid of the light and the camera because I don't need them. So I'm just going to scale and modify the cube to make it a little bit more interesting. So we'll just scale in the Y by 2. Select the top face and extrude. Scale a little bit just to create an overhang. Extrude in the Z to make a little bit of a roof. Then we will scale in the X just to make that a little bit more roofy. And scale in the Y a little bit just to give them a bit more of a taper. Now, it's also important that the model starts at origin, otherwise when you place this in Flight Simulator, this part of the model will be beneath the ground. So just going to grab all of my geometry and move it up by 1, and as you can see, my origin point is now at the base of the model. So going into the exporter, which as stated is already installed, I'm going to go and find my project directory, which we just created. Create a folder for it. Set up the we need an XML file generating for every model that we're going to have. Each model must have its own GUI. Just gonna set that up. Set a name for our model. And there's many other options available, none of which we're going to worry about at the moment. And press export. Hopefully now if we look in our models directory, we should see our XML file, our GLTF file, and a bin. We need to make a modification to the XML file. So just open that in any text editor. Change the 1.0 for the version to 1.1. So now that we have our model, we can go into Flight Simulator and begin to actually build our project. So in Flight Simulator, make sure you're in developer mode. If not, just turn it on. This is a pre-started game, which is just saved, paused rather. So is my scene. So we need to turn on the developer camera. This is the toolbar for all the development tools. So we also want to now create our project. So new project, go and pick our the root of our project directory. So we called our project my project, so select there and set our name. I'm using my project, which is the default, so press OK. So we now need to start creating packages to install to hold our models and scenes and so on. So we can press there, create our model, make sure we've got our proj selected, and press create. Here we've created our package. We'd like to have, I'm going to default my company name to this. And just make sure that I've got this name correctly. So we now need to set the type of this to scenery. And in our project we have our art proj here. We also need to add a BGL. So just clicking here, select BGL, press edit, and now we can go into our, if it helps if I click the right one, click on that one. There in the end. So change this to scene, and we're going to set our asset output to our scene directory, and our output path here needs to be this. Now going to make the same or similar settings to model. So we go and pick our root of our models directory, and again set the output path to that. Save our project, and we should now be able to click onto our package and go ahead and build it. So down here you can see our house has been loaded. Just move that out of the way. And now that we've built it, we're going to just reload our project. So once that's done, we're going to go and try and place our piece of geometry, our model. So we'll go to the scene editor. We'll go and select the package that we're going to save our scene into. So select there. And now hopefully we're going to be able to find our house in the list of objects that we have here. So we'll now go and find the location where we want to place our house. Once we're in developer mode, you can use keyboard shortcuts. So WASD moves you around, R pans you out, F zooms in. The if you hold down Alt, you can rotate, pan, and zoom. To go ahead and place our model, you can click Add. If you click one-click placing, then you can click multiple models in one go. We're just going to press Add here. So by using these arrows, we can move our model around by center clicking on the model. We can change this to a different mode, so here we have rotate, and by clicking again we have scale. So having placed our model into the space, we're just going to save our scene. So again, we go and pick our package source scene, and give that a title. So now that we've saved our scene, we have our model stuck in the middle of the airfield, we can go off and rebuild our package. Each time you press build, you get some values or errors shown over here. Just clear that. And now, once you have built this, you can go into your, if you were to go into your project, the items held in this packages folder are the items which you would give to someone if they want to install this. So if you take this, if you were to copy this, and then go to your local app data, and in here there'll be a folder called packages, and scroll down until you find one similar to Microsoft.flightSimulator. Click into local cache, go to packages and community. You can then paste that directory into there. The next time you restart Flight Simulator, that model should be then now appear in your normal session without having to enable developer mode. Thank you.